Hello, my friends of Battery Lab. My name is Saul Montoya. Welcome to this tutorial. This tutorial is about a quick and useful procedure about how to implement multiple wells with Modflow and Modern Muse. Okay, so this tutorial is not a complete procedure, it's just the part of how you can insert from a, for example, you have a Excel like a spreadsheet, like here. Okay, you have a Here you have a schedule of pumping, and as well as, sorry, I will use LibreOffice this time because we promote open source software. Okay, great. Okay, so here you have a number of wells. We have actually 182 wells, and those wells are pumping for each month. Are pumping for 1 month, but there are three wells that are pumping for 2 months. Okay, they have different the majority has data for 1 month, but three wells has data for 2 months, and then we are going to sort how Modern Muse deal with this under the feature that we were going to present. Okay. And then we have the position, the elevation of the well screen, no, the elevation, the screen. Here, this is the position, this is the elevation of surface, this is the well bottom, this is where the well is located, and these are the schedule. Most of them is from zero to this number in second, and for three wells we have from this number to this number in seconds, and this is the pumping rates in cubic meters per second. Okay, so let's start. We are going to open. You are going to, first of all, I'm going to close this because you are going to have this on the description of the video, and you are going to have all of these files. Okay, from now on we can go, and then on model we open a model. There is already a model here, and this model is the geometry where we are going to insert the pumping, the wells, the pumping wells. Okay, here we have a model. We go to time, and then the model runs on on a steady state, and then on transient. Okay, this is the first month, this is the second month, and everything is in seconds. Okay, how do we import multiple wells? Okay, actually there is a way to do it in the shapefile, but it's kind of that you have to generate a shapefile from your table and so on, and maybe this is not such a nice this is not such comfortable for the user. There is another way. How we do it? We go to file, we go to import, and then we're going to points. We go to points. Okay, and here on points we say set value of intersected cells, set value of intersected cells with one set formula. Okay. Okay, nothing else, and then we are going to apply to the well package, because in the model the well package is active, and then if you have another boundary condition, those will appear in this list. Okay, great. So far you are doing great. Okay, and then if you go to data, you actually have the position, you have the starting time, the ending time, and the pumping rate. Okay, I will decrease. Okay, I will close it again, I will do it again, but I want to have the spreadsheet close to the. Okay, here, and then here I open this. Okay, so let's go file, import points, then one set value of intersected cells. Root name is importing points. Okay, this root name is because actually this will appear as well 1, 0 and so on. Okay, and look, you have two values for well 0. Okay, And in this, the object will be object 1 and object 2, yeah? But it will be the same. You will understand this. So just say, well record, only this, well record, yeah? Because it will be a value, a register, okay? Not will be exactly a well, okay? And the features will be for well package, okay? And then we go to data, okay? And here we put the XY of all our values, okay? Great, this is the Y. Then we put the well bottom, because those will be located in one bottom, okay? And then what else we insert? We do the initial time and the end time. This is starting time and the end time, rate. And then finally, the pumping rate. The pumping rate. You can do this from Excel as the same procedure. Okay. With this, you will have imported all the points as wells. Okay. Just do that. And then if we expand this, there are all the wells. Well, there are 187 wells that you have inserted in seconds. Okay. I will change the color because actually I don't like this color. Okay. Look, not all wells are located at the same depth. There are some shallow wells. There are another more. There are. Let's put more vertical acceleration. There are some shallow wells. There are some deeper wells and so on. Okay. And let's deal with the wells that have many. Let's deal the, with the wells that has many pumping rates. Okay. So here we have the well, and this is well record one. Okay. And is pumping on the first month. But the well record two is the same, but it's pumping in the second month, okay? And where is the well record two? Wow. Oh, it's here, it's here. Okay. And if I put the red arrow here, actually it will represent one well that is pumping on the first month and then another well that is pumping on the second month. Okay, this is how, I mean, if you have a well, a schedule like 80, if you have a schedule of pumping of 60, you have a schedule of 60 time, 60 records, because maybe you are have the schedule of pumping every month for the last 10 years or something like that. This is might be a lot of registers. There is another way, okay? But for this another way, you might need Python, and then you might need to open this GPT file on the as a XML, and then doing some stuff that maybe is a kind of intermediate level, okay? This is more basic level, okay? And if you want this intermediate level, I mean, the purpose of this tutorial is just to give you this basic layer, because you might face a simple multiple well problem. But if you want to deal with a complex, okay, if you want, there is a procedure that you can insert, for example, I mean, that you can have on your Model Muse all the schedule here. Okay, if you want this, I will give you my, this is my email, Okay, because I want to hear that from you. If this is actually actually appearing to my mind. So if you are really dealing with something like as that, as specific as this, just send me an email and then we might like find a project and then do this Python code. Okay. Okay, great. Or maybe, and this will be the same procedure whether it's for wells or whether it's for wells or whether it is for observation points. That's the same. Okay, great. So, and then you just save your project and then you will have with this all your wells implemented with the pumping rate. Okay? By the use of file import points. Okay, so this is the tutorial. We are Hatari Labs. We are a blog dedicated to knowledge sharing and open source software, mostly in groundwater modeling and Python. I hope that our tutorials will be helpful for you because this is the main intention, that if you are dealing with your thesis, if you are dealing with something that like there is documentation and most of the answers are for all your questions are in the documentation, but it might be that our tutorials will give you a better glimpse and quicker glimpse on certain procedures. Okay, if our tutorials are value to you, we are happy for that. And if you find our tutorials valuable, please give it a like to this video, follow through our YouTube channel, and share it through your social networks. Okay. Have a great day. My name is Sol Montoya from Lima, Peru. See you in coming tutorials. Bye bye. Bye.